The minds of young Minnesotans were put to the test today in downtown Minneapolis. The 80th annual State Science and Engineering Fair is being held at the Marriott City Center this weekend. Students from all over Minnesota compete in the fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. We had the opportunity to catch up with just a handful of the many brilliant-minded youngsters.
Worms are used as a comparison to humans.
Shika Kumar is not your average eighth grader.
They have very similar biological characteristics to human processes.
Her project at the Minnesota Science and Engineering Fair used worms to see how sugar affects the human lifespan.
So it has a negative impact when you're having large, high enriched sugar diets.
Every project from the 500 middle and high school students was distinctive in its own way.
My project was on if screens affect your reaction time. I found that reading on the screen showed the most improvement, and both of the screen activities showed improvement from the baseline reaction test.
My project is designing a four-bladed horizontal wind turbine. To put in short, it's basically to design a windmill.
We found that humans can tell apart natural and artificial smells. We think it can be used, it can go far and be used for medical purposes.
The similarity between each one was the hope to change the world.
1.3 billion people in the world are living without electricity. That's about 4 out of every 25 people. So I want to give those people electricity at a really low cost.
Whether it's testing the efficiency of electricity or the effect of olive oil on the rate of photosynthesis.
And if they don't have that sunlight, they wouldn't be able to make oxygen, which we need.
Each student represents the future of science and engineering.
I did the science fair when I was younger, but these students here really blow my projects away. I never got past the school level, so it's really inspiring to see these students and see how complex their projects are and how much thought and time they put into them.
Students compete for awards totaling in $25,000, sponsored by 40 corporations, government agencies, and professional scientific societies. The competition runs through tomorrow, when 5 students will be named to compete at the International Fair. I think a lot.